Today, we are going to walk through a day in the life of a developer before and after using Port. Now, as developers, all we really want to do is be writing code, but currently delivering a feature to production takes too long. So if you imagine you've been given a task of deploying a new feature on a new service that you're not too familiar with, we spend a lot of time finding the resources that we actually need, and then trying to create a developer environment that's ticket ops, that's back and forth with DevOps. And same with when we want to provision any cloud resources, that takes too long. And then when we finally open a pull request, we have to send Slack reminders to get our review. And then when we actually get around to deploying something, more ticket ops, more back and forth, more waiting for DevOps. Really, there's just a lot of friction and it takes far too long. With Port, all of that changes. Everything we need is at our fingertips. So you can find all of your resources instantly, whether those are pull requests, Jira tickets, deployments, or your services. Everything you need is in one place. And with Port's self-service actions, we can create things like new services, new developer environments, or provision cloud resources on demand. There's no tickets, there's no waiting, there's no friction, no back and forth with DevOps. Everything we need in one place. What I want to do is walk you through what that could look like as a developer. So if you take the scenario, I'm a developer, I've been given a new task, implementing an OAuth 2 authentication flow, and I've not done that before. I want to show you how that actually works with Port. So with Port, I would come to these customizable dashboards, and I would find the new task that I've been given in here. And this task has all the information that I need. Port has brought it all into one place. I can see the issue URL, I can see the related services, and any other important resources that I need to know about, whether those are dependencies or feature workflows. So we can look at our related resource. In this case, it is the authentication service. And here we can see details that we need to know with the last committer, any Slack channels, the repo URL, any dashboards that we need to know about, whether that's Grafana or anything else. We can see the README. We can also ingest any APIs that we need to know about. So really easy for me as a developer, I can immediately start coding. I know where everything is and I can start making real impact. Then I might decide, actually, now I need a developer environment. So before I'd have to submit ticket, wait, delays. And with Port, I can just come in here and I can create a developer environment very quickly. And we can choose a team, we can give it a TTL, and this is completely customizable up to your company standards. And we can create this for the authentication service. And then we can see the logs, we can see how this is progressing. And then we can see we've just created this new developer environment in seconds rather than hours. This ensures that you can have that consistent, reproducible dev environments aligned with how you want that production setup, without using the tickets and without all of the bottlenecks. And then we decide, great, we've got our dev environment, we've done more work, and we now need an S3 bucket. So we can do that very easily as well. We can come here, use another self-service action, and create this new S3 bucket, March, for example, and then we can do that for our developer account. And again, I don't have to create tickets. I just click and provision what I need instantly. Brilliant. And then finally, now I need to deploy. And before, without Port, it's slow, it's approval heavy. But with Port, I can go to my authentication service and I can again use a self-service action to deploy an image. Very straightforward. And we can then deploy this to production with just a click. So deployments stay controlled, but they take seconds instead of hours. So again, very straightforward to do. Less process, more coding. There's not all the tickets, delays, bottlenecks, constant Slack pings. You can just use the self-service tools, the cataloging, to bring everything together in one place and remove all of that friction and make time for developers to actually do their coding. And from the manager perspective, the beauty of this is that they get real-time insights as to what's going on across the entire organization. So we can do things like create dashboards with Dora metrics, and we can see deployment frequency over time. we can see the mean lead time for changes. So managers know what's happening in one place as well. And you can break it down by team and see how team vision, for example, are doing. And we can create scorecards to see how productive they are and where we can help remove bottlenecks. So Port transforms the developer workflow. Without Port, it's slow, it's ticket-based, it's manual. And with Port, it's self-service, it's developer-first, and it gives visibility to what you're doing and makes life much easier. So this is really how modern engineering teams should be working.